Everybody, it's your girl Britt Breck on Live with the Breed Talk. And before we even dissect, get into this JoeBudden versus CrissleWest situation, let's like, comment, and subscribe. Tap that notification bell so you can get all the updates and alerts. And remember, opinions are not facts. So that being said, baby, I can't believe two of the podcasts I listen to are getting into it. You see what I'm saying? But I really do feel like it's JoeBudden's fault because he crossed the line, and I'm going to explain why. So for those that don't know, JoeBudden released the audio, not the visuals, of episode 261, No Cohesion. Excellent message. I was loving it until he said in the midst of the interview, you know, like that bum ass who does the podcast, which he was talking about CrissleWest. But let's backtrack. What was he talking about? He was talking about ASAP Rocky, my bad, and his situation where he's still in Sweden prison. A lot of celebrities are banding together, like signing petitions, spreading the hashtag of justice for Rocky, right? The issue is a lot of people are on the fence about it because of the things ASAP Rocky has said and done. And I'm going to explain that at the end of this video. So he had a great message and he was just like, why can't we just, you say something and then you grow from it. You know, it's a mistake. And I'm just like, okay, I agree with that. I do. You know, we can agree to disagree. I definitely understand that because you may not feel the same way you do 10 years from now. And that's definitely the truth. I mean, how many instances have we seen where somebody said something when they was 12 and they're bringing it back up and they're 35 now? You know, I get it. But like I said before, the internet is a tricky place. The internet never lets you forget. So as long as you're empathetic to a degree and you apologize for your wrongdoings, I don't feel there should be an issue. Fast forward. CrissleWest was on the read on the podcast with Kid Fury, and they were talking and they were discussing ASAP Rocky. Now, for those who don't know, she is a pop commentator. She's been one for a long time. She has been in her lane, in her bag for the longest. So I was just like, okay, here she was pretty much saying, like, you know, this is the same man who said, like, black lives doesn't matter and I'm a rich black nigga and I don't feel I should have to stand up for everything. Everything isn't a black issue, et cetera, et cetera. So she was giving her standpoint. Here's where it got a little muddy in the water. JoeBudden pretty much called her a bum ass. I mean, he talked about her. Someone put the tweet out there. She responds to the tweet. He then goes into saying, you know, she doesn't have the acumen to secure deals and all this other stuff. And I was like, wow, we could have kept it on topic. Joe, why are you taking it there? But okay, I guess because she took it there, she was just like, you know, I paved the way for him. So why would he, you know, X, Y, and Z? Joe decided to get a little dirty. I give it to CrissleWest. She has not taken it dirty yet. And I do say yet because, you know, we all know JoeBudden has a past. We've seen his past unfold on Love & Hip Hop, in the news, etc., etc. She didn't take it there. She just kept it strictly professional. She was just like, I'm not about to argue with this bum-ass nigga. You know, I got deals, blah, blah, blah. My issue with the whole Joe taking it to the muddy water situation, calling her a bum-ass, talking about she doesn't make good business deals, saying her podcast was dying, you're opening yourself up for critique. And then her responding back to you, if she takes it there, then it goes into that stereotype of black women cannot function with black men because it's a power struggle and the dynamics and et cetera, et cetera. And I'm just like, I don't agree. You know, we can agree to disagree, but why do we have to take it there? And let's not act like ASAP Rocky is innocent. He went fighting in another country in the streets. It was recorded. This Swedish man was jumped. So he filed a complaint or pressed charges. I don't know what they call it over there in Sweden. And so he's in jail because he did the crime. Now, I will say this. Do I feel he should be in prison? Am I laughing about that? No. But at the same time, y'all have to understand, you cannot go to these other countries thinking you big bad and whoop-de-whoop and think they're not going to hold your ass to the standard, period. I don't play in other countries. I respect the laws. As long as I'm doing what they say do not do, hell, you will have a good time. We need to stop thinking because we're American, we could just do and say anything in these people's countries. It doesn't work like that. It doesn't work like that. Before you get off the plane, you have to sign saying this is what you're coming here for and leave. And if you disobey, you will go to jail, for those who are well-versed and well-traveled. For my travel alums, am I lying or am I telling the truth? That's all I'm saying down below in the comments. Secondly, a lot of people are against ASAP Rocky because of what he said. He said Black Lives Matter was just some type of facade. It was just something that was going to go away. He was along a long list of black celebrities who felt the same way, but guess what? It didn't. Then he said, just because I'm black, I don't have to stand up for all this stuff and X, Y, and Z. He said these things. He also said, I'd rather talk about lean and shit like that because I'm a rich nigga in Soho. Now your Soho ass is in Sweden jail. And oh, by the way, the prime minister of Sweden said, no, they have a nice bed, they have a desk and a TV. He is not in deplorable conditions. Don't let him lie. He broke the law, so now he has to adhere to the law of our country. It's the same if someone from out of the country did it in America. And y'all know this. I don't even know why we're here right now. I'm not saying he deserves to be in jail, but you were out there fighting. I saw the video now. And if it was really that big a deal and he harassed your friend, why didn't they press charges? Why didn't they do what they needed to do? You see what I'm saying? So we have to be very clear and make smart and sound judgments when we're out here passing judgment too. And for all the ones who are saying he deserves to be in jail, that is fucked up. And do I feel like we do need some more cohesion? Yes, we don't let people live it down and grow and things like that. But like I said before, where is his people at? That's all I'm gonna say about that. And Joe, don't sling mud. Don't sling mud when you don't want someone slinging mud on your name. That's all I'm gonna say, because you were just talking about how last year you was broken, et cetera, et cetera, and how you're grateful for these deals in your life and whatnot. That's all I'm saying about that. What is your opinions? What are your thoughts? This is what's going on. Let's wait for it to unfold. It's sad because I listened to them both. But anywho, bye hoes.